Hello Super Sad Maniacs and welcome back to my channel. The most requested video on this channel, at least since I've begun doing Photoshop editing to bodybuilders, is building the perfect bodybuilding physique using different body parts from different bodybuilders depending who has the best certain body part. And I admit that I avoided to do this simply because I didn't know how to approach this. Until now. So how I'm gonna actually do this? Well, I'm gonna have a bodybuilder as a starting point for each mandatory pose, and I'll improve what's needed to be improved for that respective athlete in that respective pose, borrowing different body parts from other athletes or just enhancing their own body parts. If you didn't get that 100%, don't worry, everything will be much clearer as we go on through the process, and we begin with the front poses. 9899 Ronnie Corman is the obvious choice for the front double biceps as the starting point, but for the front lat spread, some would argue that Dorian is a better choice, and I agree, but I chose Ronnie because other than the lats themselves, Ronnie kinda beats Dorian at everything else in this pose, which brings the question, is really Dorian better than Ronnie in this pose? Well, this is a question for another video. For now, let's just start by giving Ronnie Dorian's lats and shoulder width. Boom! If you pay attention, Ronnie's got some better forearms for the front double biceps as well. More specifically, Phil Heath's forearms. The next obvious improvement Ronnie would need is the midsection for both poses. Boom! A sucked in midsection always looks much better in the front poses if you ask me. I used the Chris Bumstead's midsection and I believe it fits very well here. What do you guys think? There is one more thing we can improve here. It's true that Ronnie Corman has probably the best wheels of all time, but he can use some calf improvement. I tried to attach somehow Dorian's incredible calves here, but due to their different posing styles, this was tricky, so I ended up just improving Ronnie's calves. And boom! What do you guys think about the front poses so far? Up next we have the side poses, and I decided to have 2020 Olympia Big Ramy as the starting point, and obviously the first thing I would change is the arms for both poses. Boom! I've decided to go on with Phil Heath's arms. There can be arguments on why not Rolly Winkler or Kevin Levroni, but I did not choose Rolly because he usually holds the side try in a different style, and Kevin did not have such good forearms as Phil. Overall, I chose to go with the most complete arms in history, buys, tries, forearms, and also delts, and I'm satisfied with the result. Big Ramy already has a great chest and a good midsection, and with Phil's arms he looks just nuts, and especially combined with that crazy side leg. But the thing that lets him downstairs is the calves, so let's do something about it. Boom! I added Kai Greene's incredible calves, and in this moment the transformation for the side poses is complete. What do you guys think? Well, for those of you who don't agree with my choice, I have also an alternative for the side poses. Ronnie Corman in the side chest and Sean Roden in the side try as a starting point. Sean Roden looks perfect in the side triceps overall, aside from the triceps themselves, which are very flat. But boom! Let's give him also Phil's triceps and compare him to our enhanced Big Ramy. Sean doesn't need improved calves, his side leg is also very impressive, and he is peeled. Let me know in the comments below which one is the best side triceps. Also, let me know if 2003 Ronnie Coleman in the side chest without any improvements is better than our improved Big Ramy in this pose. Okay, enough with the side poses, let's get to the back and let's start with the back double. Dorian and Ronnie are the best ever in this pose, with only Phil Heath maybe being at the same level. But I decided to go with these two, with these specific two shots, which conveniently have similar angles. Obviously, Ronnie beats Dorian at every other aspect other than the back, where it's debatable, and the calves, but because of the angles that are not really really the same, Ronnie's calves match up pretty well with those of Dorian. Have I scaled Dorian bigger, the rest of his body, and especially the upper body, would have been unrealistically too big in comparison to Ronnie's. Anyway, my question is Dorian's back better than Ronnie's back? Well, let's give him Ronnie's arms and wheels and find out. Boom! What do you guys think about this? If you ask me, something just looks fishy, and it's probably because Dorian is drier, whereas Ronnie is well conditioned, don't get me wrong, but he's more balloonish, if that's a word. He is fuller. But anyway, this Dorian with Ronnie's limbs hybrid is quite impressive. Who's got the better back, Ronnie or Dorian? I think having the same arms and legs can help making a decision. One thing that I notice is that Dorian's traps are bigger and more impressive, in this pose at least, so let's see how Ronnie would look with Dorian's traps. Boom! What do you guys think? Who is better between Dorian with Ronnie's arms and legs and Ronnie with Dorian's traps? Let me know down in the comment section. As for a conclusion in this pose, I think 2003 Ronnie Coleman in the back double biceps is already perfect as it is. We can use some better calves maybe, but I'll improve the calves in the back lat spread for you guys. So in the back lat spread, we start again with Dorian and Ronnie. If in the back double Dorian's traps looked better, in this pose Ronnie's traps are clearly superior. But just like in the front lat spread, Dorian wins the lats. So let's give Ronnie those lats. Boom! What do you guys think? What I think is that we need Dorian's calves as well, and this would be the perfect rear lat spread pose. Boom! This Ronnie Coleman rear lat spread with Dorian's lats and calves is the perfect rear lat spread pose. Let's give that a test against 2017 Mr. Olympia Phil Heath, but with Phil having wide clavicles. The angles are different, so the scaling may be off, but regardless of that, which one do you guys think is the better rear lat spread? Let me know down in the comment section. Okay, for the last two poses, I chose my favorite abs and thighs and most muscular poses of all time, Sean Roden and Phil Heath. This Sean Roden abs and thighs is perfect as it is for me, so I'm gonna leave it untouched. I wouldn't change anything here. As for Phil's most muscular, as impressive as it is here, his arms are still a little too dominant, because of his crazy arms and narrow structure that makes his chest look squeezed and small. But if Phil had a Marcus Rule-like frame, something similar to this, his most muscular would be really unstoppable. What do you guys think? Do you agree with my approach for this video? What did I do good? What did I do bad, and what did I do ugly here? Make sure you let me know down in the comment section. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it, and also subscribe for more videos like this. Thank you guys, and see you next time.